Hello, Darren Alf here from BicycleTouringPro.com. And as the Bicycle Touring Pro, I am always asked about my bicycles. What kind of bike do I ride, and which kind of bicycle do I recommend? Now today, I'm not going to talk about the type of bicycle that's going to be best for you, because I've already written a book about this subject called The Essential Guide to Touring Bicycles, and I have a complete video course that I've created designed to teach you how to look for the best touring bicycle for you. So if you're in the process of shopping for a new touring bicycle, I recommend you look at those two resources, The Essential Guide to Touring Bicycles and my video course all about buying your first touring bike. Now today I'm going to talk about my bicycle collection. I currently only own 3 bicycles, which might be a surprise to some of you. I know a lot of bike nuts have like a whole big collection. Not me, I'm a bit of a minimalist and I like to get rid of any bikes that I'm not using, or any products really, or items that I'm not using I get rid of. So I used to have like a dozen different bicycles, but I've sold them or given them away, and now I currently have 3 bicycles, which I'm going to share with you right now. I've got my Chumba Ursa 29 plus bikepacking bicycle, I've got my Komotion Siskiyou touring bicycle, and I've got another Komotion touring bicycle called the Pangea. So the first bike we're going to look at is my Komotion Pangea touring bicycle. I got this bicycle back in 2012 and immediately rode it across Iceland. Spent 25 days riding this bike across Iceland. Now the bike was white when I first got it, but I painted it black at some point several years into my bicycle touring adventures. I don't know if I like the white or the black more. Sometimes I kind of like the white a little bit more than the black. Leave a comment down below. Let me know which color do you like more. But this is an amazing on-the-road, off-road touring bicycle that can basically go anywhere, and that's kind of why I got this bike, is because I knew I wanted something for round the world travel. The thing that makes this bike ideal for bicycle touring pretty much anywhere in the world is the fact that it's equipped with 26 inch wheels and tires. So these tires and wheels and spokes can be found pretty much anywhere in the world. If a spoke were to break, or the rim were to break, or the tire were to explode or something, I could find a replacement part for this bicycle no matter where I was in the world. And so that's why I chose this particular bicycle for my bicycle touring adventures. And I have ridden this bike across more than 50 different countries all around the world. I've probably got close to about 100,000 miles on this one bicycle alone. So this is a very good high-end touring bicycle for round-the-world travel. The bike is made out of steel, so the frame of the bike here is made out of steel. It's comfortable and easy to repair. The frame also has these joints on them. This is called an S&S coupler, and there's another one down here, and these joints allow me to split the bicycle in half. So the frame of the bicycle splits in half, and I can fold the entire bicycle up inside an airline-friendly travel case, so that when I'm flying to a new country, the bicycle folds up, fits inside of basically like a big suitcase, and I can fly my bicycle for free without paying an extra charge with the airline. So those S&S couplers have really saved me like hundreds and hundreds of dollars over the long run, even though they cost me about $800 to install when I got the bicycle initially. So very, very cool. What else? The bicycle is equipped with 2 water bottle cages here inside the main triangle of the bicycle, but there's also a third water bottle mount down here by the bottom bracket of the bike. And that third water bottle really comes in handy when you're cycling through long stretches. Like when I was in Africa and stuff, it was really nice to have that extra water bottle down there. You could also use that water bottle mount to carry your fuel canister or something like that. A lot of bike tourists do that as well. Down here we've got the traditional metal chain and derailleur, which you see on so many bicycles. But you'll see in a moment though that this is not something that you'll see on my new Komotion touring bicycle. I have a new sort of setup down here, and we'll talk about that in just a moment. But the bike is also equipped with fenders on both the back and the front of the bicycle, so these fenders help me to keep the mud and rain and snow and dirt and grime off of me and my bicycle while I'm riding. The bike has these bar end shifters, so I shift gears with here and over here. The bike has a handlebar bag, which I've added. This is the Ortlib Ultimate 6 handlebar bag. I've got a basic Cat Eye bike computer here. It tells me my speed and distance as I'm riding. The bike has drop handlebars, which is kind of common on a lot of like American-made touring bicycles. And Komotion has these drop handlebars on pretty much all of their bikes. But these handlebars allow you to have multiple hand positions while you're riding. So you can put your hands here or here or here or down here or here while you're riding. And that's very important when you're going on a long distance bike tour. You want to have a lot of hand positions so you don't suffer from nerve damage while you're riding your bicycle. The bike is also equipped with front and rear racks. So I have an Arkel front rack up here and a Axiom rear rack here on the back of the bicycle. Attached to the front and rear racks, I have a set of waterproof Ortlib panniers. So these big blue bags on the back of the bicycle are the Ortlib Bikepacker Plus panniers. And I carry like my tent and sleeping bag and sleeping pad and food and all kinds of stuff in these rear bags. And then up here on the front, I have the Ortlib waterproof Sportpacker Plus panniers. I usually carry my clothes and toiletries and stuff in these front panniers. You'll also see that the bike is equipped with disc brakes down here. These are cable disc brakes, not hydraulic. And yeah, that is the Komotion Pangea overall. This is an amazing touring bicycle. Like I said, I've taken this bike around the world, and it really is a bicycle designed for on-road as well as off-road bicycle touring adventures. If you are planning to go to remote corners of the world, this is definitely a bicycle to consider. Now, the second bicycle in my collection is this one here. This is the Chumba Ursa 29 Plus bikepacking bicycle. And this is essentially a mountain bike that has been designed specifically with bikepacking in mind. Now, one of the first things you might notice about this bicycle is that it's got some really fat tires on the bike. And these tires make the bike ideal for riding in off-road conditions, but they are also tubeless tires. And that means there's no tubes in the tires, which makes the bicycle really lightweight. It also means that if you run over a thorn or a piece of glass or something, that these tires will basically self-repair. So you don't get as many flat tires on a bike like this as you would on a regular tubed road tire. So very, very cool. This bike is made out of steel. It's got a traditional metal chain and derailleur like you would see on so many other bicycles. It has cabled disc brakes. You'll see them up there on the front of the bike. There's obviously on the back as well. And there are flat handlebars, similar to what you would see on so many other types of mountain bikes. Now, the thing that really makes this bicycle unique is the fact that the frame of the bike, as well as the fork, have a number of different eyelets on them. So eyelets are these little holes, like here for example, where you can attach racks or water bottle cages or all sorts of things to your bicycle. And so this bicycle can be configured in a bunch of different ways. You could set this bicycle up with like the racks, front and rear racks, like you saw on my Komotion Pangea just a moment ago, and you could carry panniers on the front and back of the bike in a traditional bicycle touring setup. Or you can set up the bicycle in a way like you see it here with a more traditional bike packing setup. So I've got a whole set of Wanderlust Gear bike packing bags on the bicycle right now. I'll kind of walk you through some of them, but this is the seat pack. I carry my sleeping bag and some of my clothes inside there. This is the frame pack. I usually carry my tripod, clothes, food, and stuff in there. This is an accessory pack, and I've chosen to mount it here. A lot of people will put it here on the side of the fork and put another one on the other side of the fork, but I only have one of these bags and I use it here. I have my sleeping mat inside this bag. There are currently 5 water bottles mounted to this bicycle. Another good thing about this bike is you can carry lots of water, which for me was something that I was really looking for in an off-road adventure bike, was the ability to carry lots of water and not have to carry it on my back. So right now I have 1, 2, 3, and then 4, 5 water bottles on this bicycle. If I wanted to, I could remove this accessory bag and put a really big water bottle down here or a smaller bottle down there as well. Up here, I've got a small like feed bag or accessory bag. I usually put my camera and snacks and stuff in there. These bags I use to carry my water bottles, but you could put food or snacks or your camera in there as well. I've got 2 handlebar bags up here at the front of the bike. So I've got this larger handlebar bag, which I carry my tent and some of my other clothes and food and stuff inside. And then I've got a smaller, this is probably my favorite bag on the entire bicycle, smaller handlebar bag, which I use for my map, smartphone, keys, snacks, anything that I want to get to easily while I'm riding my bicycle goes up here inside this bag. So this is really an amazing off-road bicycle touring vehicle. This is a bike made for bikepacking, off-road bikepacking, but it can be used on the road. But I honestly have ridden this on paved roads for several miles, and like it's okay for the first mile or so, but really it's not something that I would want to ride on a paved surface for very long. So if you're planning an off-road bicycle touring adventure, this certainly is a bicycle that I could highly recommend. The third and final bicycle in my collection is this one here. It is the Komotion Siskiyou Touring Bicycle, made by the same company, Komotion Cycles, that made my first bicycle, the Komotion Pangea. And if you look at the frame geometry, you'll see that the geometry of the frame is basically the same, like almost identical to the Komotion Pangea. There are, however, 2 things that are very, very different about this bicycle when you compare them to the Pangea Touring Bicycle, which I showed you just a moment ago. The first thing is that this bicycle is equipped with 650B wheels and tires. So the wheels and tires on this bicycle are a unique size that you won't see on a lot of other touring bicycles. Most touring bicycles have like 26 inch or 700C wheels and tires. So if you're doing a road-based bike tour, you usually have 700C wheels. And if you're doing an off-road bike tour, you probably have 26 inch wheels and tires. This bike has something in between. So this bike rides a whole lot like a road bike, so it's very similar on paved surfaces to riding a bicycle with 700C wheels and tires. But because the tires on this bicycle are a whole lot fatter than the tires that you normally find on 700C road-based or sport-based bicycles, this bicycle is something that you can ride in off-road conditions and still be very, very comfortable. Now, this is a steel bicycle, just like my Komotion Pangea bicycle is. It has the S&S couplers up here on the frame, which I'm zooming in so that you can see. There's one up here at the top and one down here at the bottom. There are 2 water bottle cages on this bicycle, not 3. And that is because down here in the bottom bracket, this bicycle is equipped with a pinion gearbox. This box is not a motor. It's not an electric bike. This is a box that contains all of the gearing for this particular bicycle. So instead of the derailleurs and cassettes and sprockets that you see on a traditional bicycle of any kind, all of the gearing is inside this box, and instead of the metal chain, the bicycle is equipped with this Gates carbon drive system, which is this like carbon fiber, rubberish sort of chain that goes around these 2 sprockets, one here on the front of the bike and one here on the back. So there's no metal chain that you have to lube while you're riding your bike, and there are no derailleurs that you have to worry about like breaking off when you're riding in off-road conditions. And there is basically nothing to maintain on this bicycle other than replacing the oil inside this gearbox about 1 time per year. So this is the really big thing that makes this bicycle so unique, is the fact that it's equipped with this pinion gearbox and the Gates carbon drive system. To change gears on this bicycle, there are no shifters here or here like you would see on so many other bikes, but there is just simply this 1 gear shifter here, which allows you to shift through all 18 gears by simply turning this knob. And you don't even have to be pedaling in order to change gears. So like if you come to a stop sign and you're in the wrong gear, you can just change and continue on your way. It's really cool. I've got a basic bike computer up here on the front. Just like with the Pangea, The bicycle is equipped with drop handlebars, so you have a lot of hand positions for riding your bike. I have the Ortlib Ultimate 6 handlebar bag up here on the front. It's the exact same bag I have on the Komotion Pangea. In fact, all of the panniers on this bike are the exact same ones I have on my Pangea touring bicycle because I like them so much. Back here on the back of the bike, this is the Ortlib Bikepacker Plus pannier set. And then up here on the front of the bike is the Ortlib Sportpacker Plus panniers. I've also got front and rear fenders on this bicycle, just like I did on the Komotion Pangea. The bicycle is equipped with front and rear disc brakes. These are cable disc brakes, not hydraulic. What else? The racks on the bike are tubus racks. You can see these are steel racks, whereas the ones that I had on the Pangea were made of aluminum. So these are much better racks. Tubus on both the front and the back. And over here on the side of the bike, I'm going to run around so that you can see, I have added a kickstand, not just one kickstand here on the back of the bike, but two kickstands. So I've got one kickstand here on the back, and then I've got another kickstand up here on the front of the bike, which keeps the front end of the bicycle from moving around or falling over when you're packing your bicycle. So you can get into your bags here and you don't have to worry about this front wheel like turning and falling over on you as you ride. So in the end, the Komotion Siskiyou touring bicycle is really like a dream touring bicycle. This is the Ferrari. This is the Lamborghini of all the touring bicycles out there. This is like the bike that you dream about, and this is definitely my dream bicycle. I've had this bike for 3 years now. I've ridden it across about a dozen different countries all around the world, and I'm really looking forward to more adventures on this bicycle in the future. So there you have it. Those are my three touring bicycles, the Komotion Pangea, the Komotion Siskiyou, and the Chumba Ursa 29 Plus bikepacking bicycle. If you're interested in learning more about any of these three bicycles, I've placed a link in the video description down below to my complete review for each of these bicycles. So I've written detailed reviews with photos and more video for each of these bikes. The links to those reviews are down in the video description down below. If you have questions about any of these bicycles, do me a big favor and leave a comment down below here on YouTube. I will do my best to answer your questions as soon as I possibly can. And if you're in the process of shopping for a new touring bicycle or a bikepacking bicycle, I highly encourage you to pick up a copy of my book, The Essential Guide to Touring Bicycles, and sign up for my video course titled My First Touring Bicycle. These two resources will teach you everything that you need to know in order to go out and find the best touring bicycle for you. Now, these are the bicycles that I chose for me, but they might not be the best bike for you. The type of bicycle that you ride is going to very much depend on the type of bicycle touring that you plan to conduct in the future. So I got these bikes because I knew that I was going to do a particular type of bicycle travel. Your type of bicycle terrain might be different, and it might also require you to go out and purchase a different type of bicycle. And so that's what the Essential Guide to Touring Bicycles and my video course will teach you. It'll teach you everything that you need to know in order to go out and find the best touring bicycle for you. My video course especially will also teach you how to take a basic touring bicycle, the bicycle like it comes from your dealer or manufacturer, and put it together with all the racks, panniers, fenders, pedals, handlebar bags, and everything else that you see on these finished bicycles here, so that in the end you have a complete touring bicycle or a complete bikepacking bicycle that you can then use to conduct your own cycling adventures anywhere in the world. So if you're interested in either of those two resources, my book, The Essential Guide to Touring Bicycles, or the video course, go to my website at bicycletouringpro.com. You'll see some links right there up at the top to each of these resources, and I highly encourage you to check that information out. It's very, very valuable, and I've spent years putting this information together. So if you're in the process of shopping for a new bike, that's the book and video course that I highly recommend you use. Once again, I am Darren Alf from bicycletouringpro.com. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you would, please hit the like button on this video. Subscribe to the Bicycle Touring Pro YouTube channel if you haven't done so already. Hit the bell button next to the subscribe button so that you are alerted each and every time I publish a new video. I publish new videos about one time per week. And once again, if you have any questions about the bicycles or products that I've mentioned in this video, leave a comment down below or check out the links in the video description. I am Darren Alf from BicycleTerrainPro.com. Thank you once again for watching, and I hope to see you out on the road sometime soon.